Yo, what's up? This is JayDennis with the JayDennis Podcast. It is Tuesday, June 18th, 2019. Oh my God. I don't know if you can hear it right now, because I'm in my vehicle. But I appear and sound a lot cooler. Like physically. Like my body temperature is cooler and I'm not profusely sweating, which is the body's natural way of protection against overheating. Because since 8 a.m. this morning, and it's now 1 o'clock, till about noon, so 4 hours, I had two electricians come out. And finally, source and fix my air conditioning just in time for summer. Oh my God. So we had some blackout shades and some other ways to kind of keep the house cool. We had like 4 or 5 oscillating fans, had a swamp cooler in the outside patio that was kind of blowing into the house to help keep it cool. But the house at its lowest was always around like 78. It's like, no man, you want that shit around like 74, 75. Those couple of degrees make a huge difference. And besides, that high 70s, low 80s, like it's not circulating. It's like all like condensed in one area. And overnight, we would have to crack our windows and, you know, have all the ceiling fans on max. So, you know, roughly a week and a half of bullshit. I feel for people that live in, like, lower income areas that just don't have AC at all. They're cooking in their own house. That fucking sucks. Whew. I'm just glad that's over with. Because, like, I don't have the whole why me philosophy. Or, like, there's been times maybe earlier this year and other parts, other eras of my life where I'm just like, God, it's just always something. Something always happens to me. As if nothing bad ever happens to other people. I don't believe that whole bad things come in three shit, because I don't want to put that into the universe and make it manifest. So that if two bad things happen, the third thing next absolutely has to happen. Yeah, if bad things come in threes, then why do... Okay, you know what? I'm not going to ask the question. I was like, then why do mass shootings... Why are they defined after four people? Is it because the mass shooting itself is an event rather than individual deaths that are fucked up and need to be regulated and are totally preventable? Whew. Yeah, I don't know. I've had energy, I've gotten things done, but I've also been kind of low energy because of the heat, lack of circulation in my house, lack of cool air. And just, you know, a lot of the physical work that I've been doing. But I might need to go back and fix another clip on the podcast because I kept getting cut off with phone calls. Well, you know, I'm getting cut off with one job while I'm trying to do my other, which is podcast. You think I make a lot of money in the financial and insurance world? Think again. I make a lot more podcasting. Oh, if only, right? We'll get there. We'll get there. Same thing with YouTube. I'll get there. It's all about the long game. It's like, even though I've been on YouTube since 2013, I haven't been, like, consistent with it. If I'd been, like, consistently putting out content since 2013, I'd probably have, you know, tens of thousands of subscribers by now. Tens of thousands. There were always, like, just those little, like, bursts where I would upload a bunch of content, but then I wouldn't upload anything for months. Like, in 2016, I put up a shit ton of content, and it was kind of... consistent, but it wasn't frequently enough. Like, once a month isn't enough. But, like, I did all those Talking Nu Metals with all the Korn videos, or Korn albums, because it was leading up to the release of their new album. So it's like, by the time my YouTube channel does get bigger, there is going to be a whole archive of content in there that people can watch and can consume. Ugh. The thing that's really been getting me through the past few weeks are just the ice cold showers. Whether it's the labor or it's the hot weather, lack of air conditioning, just the ice cold showers, the nice ice cold Tahoe River, Lake Tahoe water, glacier water, that during the winter is like, what the fuck? You almost feel like you're getting like frostbite from how cold the water is. In case you didn't know this, guys, but because of the mountains and the runoffs, the beaches and water out west is colder than the East Coast. I don't know if you guys can tell right now, but I'm kind of filibustering. I don't know what filibustering right now. Filibustering. Fuck! Another fucked up news. The guitar god, God himself, even though he wouldn't agree with that statement, Dave Mustaine has been diagnosed with throat cancer. You know Dave Mustaine, the lead singer of the band Megadeth, the band that I've been talking about profusely the past year. Maybe not so much the past month, because I've been talking more about Slayer. But let's just hope that this is something that passes. Because the world needs Dave Mustaine, man. The world isn't ready for a Big Four loss. I mean, I know other people have in the Big Four have passed, but I'm talking about like the front men. Like, I know it was hard for a lot of people when Jeff from Slayer, you know, the other guitar player that's not Kerry King, passed away. And then when, like, certain drummers and other people, Cliff Burton in the 80s, it's not fun, man. It's not fun. It's not easy. But anyway, hope you guys enjoy the rest of this podcast. I kind of had a weird week, so we'll see how the recount of it goes, but basically I've maintained my streaks this entire month in terms of going to the gym and meditating. It's the longest I've gone with meditating so far, is like 17-18 days. And the last time I had a perfect month at the gym was September of last year, so just working on making it happen. Go to raptorriot.bandcamp.com to download the Sabotage EP. Helps out the podcast. It helps out the album. I will be posting more Raptor Riot teasers on this podcast and posting more music that isn't just what I'm listening to in the background and like just randomly throwing it in there. But it's all good. I don't need to create necessarily a perfect balance between everything in my life, but when one thing kind of takes over something else, I get a little less time for it. I don't know why, but just like the last week, talking for more than like 4 minutes makes me sleepy. But yeah, like the past month has been really like successful for my career, and I haven't had as much time to put into Raptor Riot, but I did front load a lot of work in the Raptor Riot last month, so it kind of helped create something. And I'm also, by the way, very excited for the new Sum 41 album that's going to be coming out, and the new Taylor Swift album. Oh! Sounds like a really tight fart. Oh shit, it's that Crash Bandicoot level, you know, like in the sands, hang time. Practically running to the beat. No, that's Insomnia, the first track from Megadeth's Risk album. I seriously wonder what it was like for like a Megadeth fan, you know, after hearing Cryptic Writings in 1997, thinking, okay, this album's a little more alternative, but there's still some thrashers on there. You know, like the Disintegrators, Vortex, She-Wolf, and then 2 years later, they pop in this album, it's 1999, and then they hear this. Ooh, a puppy! Like, if you were in that headspace 20 years ago, please let me know. I'd love to hear a story from you, Generation X. But really, though, there's only one thing I have to say right now, and that is, woo! Congratulations! Toronto Raptors, baby! Yes! I am so glad they won. They lost game 5 so that they could go win in California. That was the goal. Ugh. That last, like, 0.9 seconds and then having to reset the clock after 0 seconds. That last... ugh, it was the longest, like, 5 minutes ever. I got no hate for the Warriors. You know, I can respect a good dynasty, how fucking good they are with their three-point sharpshooters, all that stuff. There's probably not going to be another team like them for a long time. Unless the NBA keeps, you know, drifting towards this, you know, not playing in the paint, not taking it up, you know, up the alley to the rim, you know, not really being a big man's game anymore, it being all about the three-point shooters. Because that's what it came down to. The two best three-point shooting teams in the league ended up playing each other. As far as I know, statistically, the Raptors and Warriors had the highest three-point percentage. There was actually an era where the Magic were pretty consistent with their three-point shooting, and they were, like, usually towards the top. But it didn't mean anything, did it? One day, the Magic will get their first championship. Ugh! When that day comes... I don't know. Will I be at full cynicism about the NBA by that point? Who knows? But it looked like the officiating, for the most part, during the NBA playoffs and finals were pretty solid from what I saw. And if you disagree, go ahead and send me a hateful email or something, or leave a comment on the YouTube section, YouTube website. Yeah, so obviously I just finished watching the game. It's like 9 o'clock at night, and I just left the gym. I've gone 15 days in a row now, I think. Either 15 or 16, but I've gone every day this month. Meditated every day this month. So in some respects, June is an improvement. One of the more consistent months that I've had thus far. I actually woke up at the first alarm 3 days in a row. But then fucking yesterday and today, I was just a freaking bitch. I wake up at 4:30. Go downstairs to sleep on the couch till 5:15 so that, God forbid, if I keep snoozing my phone, I don't wake up my wife. That's what happens sometimes, is I'll wake up at 4 or 4:30, and some people are like, ugh, why? I'm like, believe me, if you knew what my morning rituals were and the stuff I wanted to accomplish before 8 a.m., you would know that I would need those 4 hours. If I have those 4 hours to myself, even 3.5 hours, or 3 at the least, if I had those 3 to 4 hours to myself in the morning... it makes a world of difference for my day. I get all that time to myself in the morning. So I'm able to give myself a lot more to people during the day. And of course, to my wife during the rest of the morning and the day as well. Don't think I made a podcast yet about this. But also, shout out to the St. Louis Blues. No longer the Bluesers. You guys How fucking awesome is that? Two teams, back to back. Day after day, both teams got their first championships. As far as I know, St. Louis Blues and hockey and Raptors and the NBA never won championships. So good for them. And good on Kawhi Leonard for constantly bringing some sort of amazingness with him wherever he goes. Guy's a really fucking good player. My bench press is going back up. My squat's going back up. I'm curling more. And again, I'm not going hard on the weights every single day, but I am attending. I don't just step foot in the gym and go, well, I went for the day. I at least do some cardio and a little bit of weights. Or if I don't do weights, I'll do some abs or something. But I've gone to the gym every single day. And I'd say out of the 15 days, probably like 12 of them, I've done weights. And with the meditation, it's been a little bit of a task at times. I'd catch myself, if I don't do it in the morning, sometimes I don't get to the shit, even though it's just 10 minutes of my day. Sometimes I don't get to it until like right before I go to bed and I'm like sleepy already. But I'm like, dude, you need to do it. And it's becoming almost second nature. Once you've done something for like 2 weeks, usually it becomes a habit. Whew. Damn, I'm tired. So it's Thursday night. I might be on TV tomorrow in the morning, Friday morning. I'm giving a testimony for somebody. And it's going to be on the news, I think. So I'm going to be dressed up pretty nice and looking good. You know, just looking myself. And I am working really hard towards developing a really ideal and consistent schedule that just breeds success, breeds unbridled discipline that's going to be really profitable and everything. And it's going to seem rigid to the layman, but it's actually going to be just powerful and ritualistic like this. It's not the first time I've played that on this podcast. What I've been doing the past couple days at the gym or while going to bed, somehow I'm not having like satanic dreams or anything, but I've just been choosing Slayer on my Spotify and just hitting shuffle play, so it just shuffles their entire discography. You know, it's not just playing their popular songs, it's playing like all the regular non-singles too, so I'm getting a nice mix of all their albums. Usually when I binge listen to a new band or something, or an existing band that's new to me, or that I'm revisiting, I may or may not start with their most popular album first, and then kind of work my way backwards or whatever. Usually the last albums I listen to with most bands are the least popular ones, like Megadeth, the album that I listened to last was Risk, I think. Might have been Risk or Super Collider, but that's like their two worst albums. But I got it fucking playing in the background, so I must like it, right? So yeah, fucking Raptor Riot, man. Good job, Toronto Raptors. I like should have been playing Raptor Riot in the background during this podcast, but I didn't have my iPod with me. I feel like I'm kind of at a loss for words right now in terms of what to talk about. I'm really fucking sleepy, but I'm going to podcast anyway. You want to support the podcast, go to raptorriot.bandcamp.com, download the Sabotage EP, costs $2.99, it's got three original tracks, a Limp Bizkit cover. Apparently it's also been 20 years since Limp Bizkit did that famous rooftop video. By the time this podcast is out, I will have at least one new YouTube video out, because Limp Bizkit's significant other is about to turn 20. So I want to do a video on that. Talk about what a powerful impact that album has had on me this decade. And just how nooky is kind of like the theme song to my life. Just that intro. Just everything. All right. Peace.
JayDennis, yeah!
I love you, Dave Mustaine. What day is it? Come on. Where's it at? Oh. Yeah. Okay. Alright. Oh shit, it's already recording. Hey. It's June 15th, Saturday. Saturday, June 15th, freaking like 9 o'clock at night, and I'm taking my happy ass to the gym, so I can go to every day this month, although, based on all the work I was doing earlier today, all the work I was doing throughout the course of the day, I was doing some demolition. My driveway has this annoying concrete wall that goes alongside part of it because my front yard is slightly inclined, and this is where like things were I can't even think straight. Hold on a second. I'm exhausted. Okay, so basically my front yard, it's got an incline to it a little bit from the sidewalk. And alongside the driveway, there was a little bit of gardening done where there were some bushes and some, not hedges, but mainly just bushes that were done. And it inclines up to where a little set of stairs levels up off to like where my front door's at. And what's holding all that incline in along the driveway is a concrete wall. So we're tearing down that wall, we're going to terrace all of that and do like a tea garden or something, and also make it so that, you know, if you park on that side of the driveway, if you open the passenger door, you're not going to hit a fucking concrete wall. So we rented a 20-pound jackhammer from the Home Depot, and that was the ultimate hand and wrist and other parts of my upper body workout. But I still said I was going to go to the gym every day anyway. So there's been some activity this summer where I didn't do as much weightlifting as I wanted to do, but I've been doing a lot of, you know, hard labor. You know, pouring concrete pavers and, you know, dispersing gravel. And now I'm doing the opposite. I am destroying concrete now. But, you know, in like 4 odd hours, I destroyed a good portion of it. We're gonna just end up keeping the thing for an extra day. And I'd say I got about at least 3/4 of the way done. And pretty much like 85% done with the part that really needs to be gone. So, made a lot of good progress today. As soon as I finished, you know, working in the sun and just getting dirty as fuck, of course I had safety goggles on and a little mask around my mouth, little dust mask, because there's like little freaking bits of shrapnel flying at you. And alongside this entire, you know, these two slabs of concrete that are vertical, you know, they're walls, as most walls are, there was a piece of rebar that was going along the entire thing, so I managed to freaking yank that boy out, and now I'm going to the gym to just do some cardio, maybe some abs. And if I'm feeling frisky, if my hands feel good enough, I'll maybe bust out some bench reps. But what the fuck do I want to talk about? Have I talked since like the St. Louis Blues and the Toronto Raptors won their respective championships? I mean, what else have I been up to? My dog, my beautiful German Shepherd that has these allergies, this poor guy, you know, German Shepherds, they got those big ears, right? This poor guy, he's had these little scabs on the tips of his ears since we've gotten them, because they're like allergy related, and we've given him hypoallergenic food, we've We give him allergy shots every couple months, and it improves his quality of life, and it, you know, keeps him happy and healthy, but he still has a couple of these, like, residual allergy effects, which, you know, sucks, because you think, okay, is this guy living up to his full potential of comfort? Well, we finally got some topical shit to put on his ears, and damn it, his ears look and feel normal now, so I'm really excited. Oh. I've just been really obsessed with this song lately, Breadline from Megadeth. Probably like their least known single ever. There is a music video for it, but it's off, you know, I still got Risk playing. You know, objectively speaking, it's obviously a very cookie cutter song, but just because of the key that it's in, I'm very biased to like it. It's like that summertime, like, I think it's like F or F sharp, which to me is a summertime thing, because a lot of my favorite songs growing up, like Let Me Go from Three Doors Down, Did You Think That I Was Gonna Give It Up To You from Avril Lavigne, Don't Tell Me, that's the name of the song. You know, all those songs that use like the same chord progression, and it's like the, you know, it's like the key of F sharp or some shit, I don't know, but That's how my brain operates, you know. I hear certain guitar tunings, or I hear certain keys, and it makes me think of certain times of year. Like, winter's very C sharp, summer's very F sharp, G sharp. It's mainly summer and winter. Fall is C. You can't fuck with fall. It's very much C. If any of that made sense to you, let me know. I'm sure I'm not the only person that thinks this. I know everybody that's remotely normal, when they hear certain songs, they get nostalgic and they think about certain times of their life. But as a musician, I take it a little step further, and I don't know, maybe non-musicians can do that too. You know, you hear a certain note or a certain noise and it makes you think of a certain time or time of year or whatever. What is springtime? Couldn't tell you. And of course, there's certain keys that are kind of just like year-round or whatever. Ugh! It actually kind of hurts to talk, but I want to finish this podcast. This is already gearing up to be an amazing summer, as this shit's playing. Yeah! Can't tell right now, but I'm out hanging out with the boys right now, having a couple beers, having a couple brewskis, and having a good time. Oh my god, my friend Bob just made a joke, and we are pointing at each other and laughing and going like, hey, you're the man. Yeah. Oh, here comes the punchline. You know how they do that in fucking, you know, TV shows and commercials? They got the right song playing, and it's supposed to encapsulate the moment or the feeling. Like, this is like music and psychology.
You love me, but you don't know who I am. Torn between this life and me. Did you think that I was gonna give it up to you?
Fuck. Yeah, I'm like stream of consciousness right now. I just did something awesome today, aside from tearing down a wall, you know, pulling a reverse Trump. You know, you would think the Republican Party would not want walls, considering, you know, what's his nuts, Ronald Reagan. Gorgabitch, tear down that wall. Why are we changing history? I thought the Republican Party was, like, on Ronald Reagan's dick. The wall's not gonna happen. Like, it's not. Anyway, what was I going to say? Oh yeah, so today I finished my mentorship vault. What does that mean? So I'm in a paid mentorship program right now. And you know, he's been doing it since like 2015. So when you join, you have access to like the old videos and stuff. And he does them weekly. So, you know, it's a couple years. So there was roughly 150 videos that I watched in the span of like 2 months. So like two or three a day. And I took really good notes, and these are notes that are going to help me in my career and my mindset and my life and my entrepreneurial everything. And I did some math today. And after taxes, I easily tripled my income. So this past year has been phenomenal. I made a huge career change. I don't really attract a lot of haters or a lot of negative energy because I don't put that out there. But I know I had some naysayers, I had some critics, I had some people that thought I wasn't going to do it. But if you've been listening to this podcast long enough, you know how much of a fucking hard worker that I am and how much I see shit through. There's a lot of things that I talk about that I haven't seen through or brought to fruition just yet, but they are all part of my long-term goal. My long-term goals, you know, Raptor Riot, having this podcast on fucking iTunes or something, like, it's all going to happen. And am I better off than I was a year ago? Fuck yes, I am. I'm getting better every year. I'm getting better every week, working on getting better every day. So you can put that in your pipe and suck it. Monday the 17th, about noon o'clock, and this homeless problem really needs to be curtailed. I don't know if it could ever be fully eliminated. I'm not talking about eliminating the homeless population, I'm talking about helping them, even though I do piggyback on a lot of Bill Burr's ideas of saying things like, yeah, we need a plague, we got a bit of a population problem here. And then when lovely people in my life say, like, well, what if you get it? What if you died? And it's like, you think I'm exempt? You know, I'm on the healthier side and on the slightly above intelligent side, above average intelligent side. So I think my odds are a little bit lower of getting hit by the plague. But if I'm part of it, so be it. It's for the greater good. But obviously I'm going to be a little selfish and try to put it out into the universe first, so that, you know, in a karmaic way, is that a word? Karmaic fashion, it doesn't hit me because I'm not oblivious to it. I'm prepared mentally for it. My asshole is ready for the plague. No, it's just really sad. Anytime you speculate about homeless people with other people, you really don't know what to say, because you're just like, oh, well, you know, sometimes I give them money, or I give them food, or, you know, here's a anecdote about that one time where a guy got grouchy with me because I gave him food instead of money. Oh, yeah, no, I don't give them money because they always buy alcohol and booze, because we just assume that they're all drug addicts, and it's especially hard when they are not just hurting, but they are also mentally, because you have to go insane. Many of them, like, lose their mental faculties or, like, get mentally deteriorated over time, and it really sucks. And, like, what do? Do you work on improving yourself and hope that one day you may be able to take a few of them out on a day trip with you and get them cleaned up and help turn their lives around? Oh, well, a lot of them put themselves in that situation. You know, maybe a small percentage did, but maybe a lot of them dealt with the frickin', like, foreclosures of 2008. Or, I don't know. I would like to imagine that most homeless people didn't ask to be in that position, and that maybe many of them actually they had the discipline to not end up in that position. They were just dealt a shit hand, and they didn't have the resources that some people... There are some people that never have to worry about being homeless because of the families they have and because of the kind of person they are, and or because of the kind of person they are. There are some people that never have to worry about that because they have family and resources and connections, and it's like, it's something they landed on their ass. They have a place to stay until they got back up on their feet. Whereas other people, maybe they come from out of town and they don't have connections. They don't know anybody. Hmm. Well, I just get so tired all of a sudden. Anyway, this is the JayDennis Podcast. This might just be like a shorter one, like a half hour or something. But I spent the better... Nice blinker, fuckhead. I spent the better part of the weekend using a 20-pound jackhammer and just gnarling up my hands from gripping the damn thing and tearing down a wall. And it's been torn down. On the other clip where I talk about starting, I got it down to like maybe like 75%. Well, yesterday on Sunday, I finished it. That shit was hard. And exhausting. But I got a little extra sleep, which is good because typically I'm up at like 5 or something. But this morning I overslept. I got up at like 7:30. And I needed to be somewhere at 8:30, so I was kind of rushing a little bit waking up. But I didn't feel as sore or as shitty. And I think it was because of the extra sleep that I took. Because when I woke up at 5, I was just like, ugh. But then when I woke up at 7:30, I felt less like, ugh, and more like, huh, all right. Still a little sore, but I feel like I could at least maybe do some weights today. Because I did go to the gym all weekend still, even though I was fucking getting the ultimate hand and wrist and arm workout. Made, like, a lot of full body workout. I got a little bruised up from holding the jackhammer up against myself, using my body weight, or using my body as leverage instead of having... And I would sit in a chair, too, for part of it. So that way, I could just... Because the wall is only, like, 3 feet high that I was tearing down. So there's no reason for me to stand up and bend over when I could just sit in a chair and do it. But there were certain parts where I had to get up and do that. But... So even though I was working out in the sun, sweating up a storm for like 4 hours a day on Saturday and Sunday, I still said, I said I go to the gym every day this month, and I have. And I don't just open the door and, you know, stick my foot in and go like, okay, I was there. I mean, like, no, I got to at least do some cardio. And I did. Sorry. Fuck this quality. Like, quality of content, not quality of sound. Even though you might hear the air conditioning in the background. But yeah, so we have a shit ton of broken wall, gravel, broken up concrete chunks just laying alongside the house right now. I don't know how much... Like, if I rented a truck from Home Depot and just filled the bed to the brim with this stuff, I don't know if I could just do it in one trip, but apparently there's a... one of the bigger construction companies here in town, they do destruction, or whatever, destruction, demolition, recycling. So if I wanted to drive, you know, like, half an hour out of my way to do this instead of having somebody come and pick it up and pay 18 grand or something, I could just do this myself, but like, loading the truck is going to be a bitch. But I'm just going to have to see what I can do and price it out, because it's getting to a point now where I'm like, is this shit even worth my time? I could spend this might be a 4-hour venture. Okay, that was really fucking creepy. I thought a person was standing outside holding a sign, and the sign was gyrating in a perfect circular motion. But no, it's actually a mannequin with a hat and sunglasses, and it's got the sign sticking out of the top. Sorry about that, I got a phone call, cut me off. Yeah, the sign was sticking out of the torso and just gyrating around, and it was really creepy, and it was really dead looking. And this particular portion of the podcast is actually recorded like a day later, because this particular clip kept getting fucked up, and now this is how I am ending the podcast.